Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the family counseling. See, in the previous class I have discussed with you about the how to prevent suicides or suicide prevention. So in the suicide prevention class I have clearly mentioned you about the importance of family therapy or importance of the psychoeducation and importance of the family counseling. So this class we let us discuss about the family counseling aspects. See, family counseling is one of the therapies which has been given by many proponents. See, mainly we can see that during the 1950s, Nathan Ackerman, Theodor Litz, Lyman Wiener, Murray Baum and Carl Whitaker. See, all these people, mainly these theorists, they have broken from the psychodynamics approach. Means they found that okay, psychodynamic is not, it's not only working with the individual past and present, you know, we are not only working in the past life, we need to work with the present life also. So they have broken from the psychodynamic and they have started their own theories. So they are the main proponents of the family counseling therapy. So in 1964 we can see that Virgin Chartier developed conjoint family therapy, which has become one of the very important therapy in related with the family counseling. So we'll see who are all the major family therapists are there. See, for example, Salvador Minuchin developed structural family therapy, Murray Baum developed transgenerational family therapy, and Carl Whitaker developed experiential family therapy. So on the whatever the counseling which we do today under the family counseling are backed by the theories of these major therapists. So what defines a family? Family is a group of people bound together by philosophical, religious or other convinces with a common ancestry living together under a same roof. And we can also see that family is a basic bio-social unit in society, having its nucleus two or more adults living together and cooperating in the care, rearing of their own or adopted children. So the members, like as a children, they can be adopted or they can be their own biological children. So even though adopted, they also comes under the family system. See, in the worldwide, we can see different various types of family systems or various structure of family. See, for example, traditional families like in India, joint family system, single parent families, grandparents families, where the only grandparents becomes the main elders in the family, gay or lesbian family, teenage parenthood families, divorced families. So it's not that family in the sense it's not only working with the father, mother and with their children. We need to study the structure of the various types of family in the worldwide. So as a counselor in the beginning, understanding the particular structure of the family is very important. So what is family counseling? Family counseling is an intervention in which members in a family identify and change problematic, maladaptive, repetitive relationship patterns and self-defeating belief system. So as per the Goldenberg 2008. And this is an approach treatment considers the identified patient is having a problem as a result of the transactions which happens within the family. So family counseling is mainly dealing with the problems of the individual which happens, emerges or which happens and emerges because of the family relationship. So how does family counseling is different from the individual counseling? Family counseling is only focusing upon the family and its members. Interactions and relations involves intervention to alter the way an entire family system operates. Whereas in individual counseling, it is only working with the one particular individual. Whereas in the family counseling, we need to work with all the members of the family in order to bring the coordination within all the members of the family. So some of the common family and relationship problems which is mainly dealt in the family counseling is frequent arguing, disagreements, breakdown in communication, angry outbursts, avoidance, physical contact, difference in opinions, personality, beliefs, values or goals, change in family circumstances, for example, new baby, divorce, separation and blending families, financial problems, stress, issues relating to sexuality, alcohol or drug use, gambling problems, the onset of mental health problems, bullying and harassment, natural disasters, lack of trust, respect in a relationship. So these are all the common relationship and family problems which we, you know, which we get in the family counseling sessions, or the which are all the problems which used to be addressed in the family counseling. So the impact of family and relationship problems mainly leads for the negative emotions in the family among the family members. For example, anger, sadness, anxiety, stress, exhaustion, confusion, feeling isolated, alone or withdrawal, lack of concentration, difficulty in eating or sleeping disorders, eating disorders, and in crime rate. I mean, see, family problems also leads for the increasing crimes in the family setup, using alcohol or drug abuse, or and problems with the friends, colleagues or children. So all these are all the effects of the family problem. So that is why we need to address the family issues in the family counseling. So what is the role of a family counselor? Say, family counselor is mainly addressing the issues which is connected with the particular person, which is related to other members also. He is mainly helping the family to identify the reason of conflicts or anxieties. He is the one who is helping the family to strengthen the family relationship by avoiding or by solving the problems. And he is the one person who teaches how to handle conflicts or changes differently. See, everyone gives the suggestion. I mean, if I am going through a problem in the family, if I ask my friend, they will give me the suggestion, but it may not be the technical way of solving the problem. So, but when we come under the family counseling setup, that helps you to understand the problem and what all the techniques can be followed, and technically I can be able to solve my problems in the family, so that I can, you know, restructure my family. So why it is needed? Obviously, I have already mentioned why it is needed. Mainly, see, different families have different problems. Family counseling helps to overcome these situations successfully. Example of, if a parent is having going through some problems with their children, they can successfully solve in the family counseling setup. See, family counseling setup, what are the stages? Are the stages of counseling process? Mainly, first stage is the pre-sessions planning, the joining stage, the problem statement stage, the interaction stage, in-session conference and goal setting stage, ending stage and post-session. See, pre-session, mainly therapist determines, you know, who will attend the session, who are all required in the session. The joining stage, where the counselor makes to join other family members also. The problem stage, statement stage, where actually the discussion begins, identifying the problems or identifying them in discussion stage. It's a discussion stage. Then interaction stage, mainly the therapist focus in determining the pattern of interaction, sustaining the problem. In session conference, it is a ongoing evaluation of the particular therapy which is going through in related with the problem. Goal setting stage, it is a goal setting. Therapist teach the family members what is the goal which is we need to set up and how we can go through the solve the problem. Ending stage, after goal setting or after technical application, we need to terminate the particular group. So that is the ending stage. And post session, mainly evaluation of the process which has happened throughout the from the beginning to end. So this is how the family's counseling stages go through. So family therapy techniques, a few of the techniques which we use in the family counseling are mainly circular questioning. It's not only questioning the one person, but questioning all family members. Reframing, the problem must be put into solvable behavioral terms, be referred as a family problem and not just the problem of one family member, and should be put it in the positive terms. Giving directives, creating or selecting an intervention that will impact the presenting problem. Ordeals. So ordeals is, an ordeal is a behavior that is more intolerable, frustrating. So the frustrating behaviors should be avoided, so that, you know, which is giving low frustration, that should be adopted. Rituals, symbolic acts that help by family move. For example, burying a box that contains family anger. It's a kind of a role play also is one example we can give for this. ambiguous assignments help break down linear thinking and causes the family to be more creative in problem solving. So family sculpting, re-sculpting, I mean, see, whatever the structure which we have, so the structure, it is causing the problem. If structure is causing the problem, restructuring the particular structure. So that is what comes under the family sculpture. So restructuring the relationship. If some relationship is causing problem, then we need to restructure the particular relationship. Genogram is in a kind of activity or study of the three generations or the generational study of the particular family. So that we will come to know that what are all the aspects which is there, like family dynamics, rules, patterns, mental health aspects, all those things we will come to know in the genogram. Reenactment, asking the family to act out a situation rather than describe it verbally, like a role play. So these are all the, and any person who want to go do the family counseling, he should be trained, specialized in family counseling. He should be licensed, he should get the license, and that particular his organization should be registered under the professional associations, and program accreditation has to be get, and he should make use of all ethical and legal issues. Very importantly, some of the ethics which we need to follow as a family counselor is the responsibility, confidentiality, therapist control, informed consent, and third party payments. So these are all the things which is very important in the family counseling. So so students, I can conclude this particular topic by saying that, see, nowadays we can see that lot of, you know, family conflicts are increasing, crime rates are increasing within the family setting, and lot of parent child conflicts are there, and mainly alcohol or drug abuse or many problems connected with the family is increasing, like divorce, desertion, crimes and all. So if we talk about all these things under the family counseling tree or under the roof of the family counseling, definitely we can solve many of the problems which is connected to all of us. So happy family always leads for the development of individuals. So happy family leads for happy society, and that is what we always accept. So thank you students. If any queries related with this particular topic, I think we can have the discussion.